Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a great tip that was sent in by Bill from Addison, Texas. But first, I need to mention that today is September 10th. I'm actually recording this ahead of time because this week really starts my fall Power Excel seminars. I have a bunch of them coming up. We'll be in Chicago tomorrow, September 11th, then Birmingham, Alabama. I'm actually off to Dallas for a private seminar the day after that, and then back to Akron, Ohio on Friday, September 14th. And then next week, we're going to be in Chicago the whole week, the 18th through the 20th, 3 day of Excel and Access. That's with Mike Alexander and myself in Chicago. And then the next Monday, the 24th, in Roanoke, Virginia. That's just a short seminar, about an hour and a half. And then all day again in Fort Wayne, Indiana, October 3rd, Columbus, Indiana, October 4th, and then back in Akron, Ohio all day for October 5th. So if you're anywhere within 50 miles of one of those places and like to come by for the seminar, it's a great day. Come to stop by Mr. Excel. There's a link right at the top of the homepage, complete list of upcoming seminars. We always have a link to how to register to all those. I would love to see you. Make sure to come up and say, hey, I see you on the podcast. And, you know, it'd be great to meet some of the folks that watch the podcast. Now, a few weeks ago, I talked about a cool tip where we went from basically Excel to Notepad. And Bill from Addison said, well, hey, you know, I do that all the time. And do you know that I have my system set up so that way it's just one keystroke to get to Notepad? He says it's Ctrl Alt M. Well, I tried that on my PC and of course it didn't work at all. And so I said, okay, Bill, what's the trick? I'm interested. And Bill gave me a great way to do this tip without cluttering up your desktop. He said, open Windows Explorer, go to Documents and Settings, your username, the Start menu, and create a new folder there. Bill calls his key short. You could really call it anything, he said. And then basically open Windows Explorer with that key short folder open. And then you can go to anything on your Start menu. So let's say that we wanted a shortcut to Snagit. We use Snagit for all of the screenshots for our books. I'm going to click on the Snagit icon and drag it to the key short folder. That'll create a shortcut in this folder. And then Alt-Enter will get me to the properties. Alt-K will get me to the shortcut key. Now I assign any kind of a shortcut key that will help me remember this. For Snagit, I'm going to use Control S. So we use Control S. You'll see that it puts a shortcut key of Control Alt S. Click OK. And now basically I've taken the five or six applications that I use all the time. Excel is Control Alt X. Perfect. Excel 2007, Control Alt 7. Notepad, Control Alt N. Camtasia, which is what we use to record the podcast, Control Alt C. Snagit, Control Alt S. And you can basically do this for any of the applications you use a lot. We always use QuickTime to produce the MP4. So Alt Enter, Alt K to get to the shortcut, and let's say Control Alt Q for QuickTime. Great tip, not necessarily Excel related, other than it is a very, very fast way to be able to launch Excel. If I need Excel 2007, Control Alt 7, and Excel is off to the races. So great tip, thanks to Bill from Addison, Texas. Bill already has one of my Excel master pins, so he's good to go there. And thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you tomorrow for another netcast from Mr. Excel.